Okay, let's proceed to the language of sets. So the language of sets, so we have here the notation and the meaning. First notation, so that is set. Set means yung nandoon ka sa loob, that is set. Another notation is element. Element, kung sino yung nasa loob, yun ang mga element. Next is not an element. So it means empty, walang element. Yan, XE, that is X is an element of S. So we can read that one as X is an element of S. And then X is not an element of S. So a set may be specified using the set roster notation by writing all of its elements are 1, 2, and 3. A variation of the notation is sometimes used to describe a very large set, as when we write a set of 1, 2, 3, and so on, to refers to the set of all integers from 1 to 100. A similar notation can also describe a infinite set, as when we write a set of 1, 2, 3, and so on, to refer to the set of all positive integers. The symbol ... is called an ellipsis, and is read, and so forth. Okay? So, example, let A a set of 1, 2, 3, B a set of 3, 1, 2, and C is a set of 1, 1, 2, 3, 3, 3. So, letter A, what are the elements of A, B, and C? How are A, B, and C related? Okay. So, the answer is A, B, and C have exactly the same three elements. 1, 2, and 3. Therefore, A, B, and C are simply different ways to represent the same set. Okay, kung makikita nyo, si set A is 1, 2, 3. Set B is 3, 1, 2. So, the number inside, the elements are the same, 1, 2, and 3. And letter C, set of C is 1, 1, 2, 3, 3, 3. Although they are repeating numbers like 1, 1, and 3, 3, 3, but the concept is the number or the elements inside A, B, and C is only three elements, which is 1, 2, and 3. Okay, letter B. Is a set of 0 equal 0? The answer is a set of 0 is not equal to 0 because is a set with one element, namely 0, whereas 0 is just the symbol that represent the number 0. Hindi sila equal kasi yung isa, si set of 0, nakaset kasi siya. Yung equal niya 0, wala siyang set. So, hindi sila pwede magka-equal. So, para magiging equal sila, dapat the same sila set. A set of 0 equal a set of 0. Gets niyo ba? Okay, next. How many elements are in the set? Okay. So, a set of 1 and a set of 1. So, the set 1 and a set 1 has two elements. 1 and the set whose only element is 1. Okay. Although they are the same element inside, but the representation is different. Gets niyo ba? So, nasa set ang dalawang 1. Pero yung isang 1, nasa set sa loob at nasa loob pa din. Ganun ba? Ganun. Okay, letter D. For each non-negative integer n, let u sub n equal a set of n and negative n. Find u sub 1, u sub 2, and u sub 0. All you have to do is to substitute the values. Okay, answer, u sub 1. So, find u sub 1. The formula is U sub n equal a set of n and negative n. So U sub 1, so 1 and negative 1. So, kung anong yung number dito sa U, so yun ang isa-substitute mo. Then U sub 2, so substitute the values 2 and negative 2. U sub 0 equal a set of 0 and negative 0, or equal to 0, a set of 0 and 0, or a 0, a set of 0. So all you have to do is to substitute the values by the given set, which is n and negative n. So whatever the value of u, substitute here in n. Did you get? Okay, next, check your progress. Let x equal a set of a, b, and c, y equal a set of a, b, c, and z a set of a, b, b, c, c, c. Now, what letter A, what are the elements of x, y, and z? How are x, y, and z related? Letter B, how many elements are in the set? A set of AB and a set of A. Letter C, for each positive integer x, let A sub x equal x, set of x, and x squared. Find A1, A sub 1, A sub 2, and A sub 3. For letter C, substitute all the values. A sub 1, substitute nyo dito sa x. A sub 2, yan si 2, substitute nyo dito sa x din. At saka si A sub 3. Now, comment below your answers. Next, set builder notation. Let S denote a set, and let P of X be a property that elements of S may or may not satisfy. We may define a new set to be the set of all elements X in S such that P of X is true. We denote this set as follows. So ito yung sinasabi. So X element S. So pagbasa niyan is the set of all element X in X in S. So ito is such that P of X is true. Okay? So again na ang pagbasa nito is the set of all elements X in S. Okay, next. Okay, real number system. So all these numbers that you can see, we call that ones as real number system. So lahat ng numero na nakikita ninyo, ang tawag diyan is real number system. Now, so under the real number system, ikinakategorize niyan. Nihimay-himay ba? Kumbaga, kinakategorize. First is the Q, which is the rational numbers. In rational numbers, it should be a fraction or a whole number. That is irrational numbers, but not equal to zero. Or fraction means 1/4, whole number, which is 2, 6/8, that is fraction. We call that one as rational numbers. Z, which is integers. Integers is all positive and negative whole numbers, including zero, that is integers. Positive and negative whole numbers including zero, that is integers. When we say positive integers, only from 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. When we say negative integers, that is negative from negative 1, negative 2, negative 3. 0 is not included for positive integers and negative integers. Okay. Next, whole number. Whole number means from 0, 1, 2, 3, and so on. No more negative. That is whole number. No more negative. Natural numbers. Natural number starts with 1. No 0. 1, 2, 3, 4, and so on. Irrational numbers. Irrational number, that numbers are those square root, cube root, ganun, pi. That is the irrational numbers. All in all, these all numbers, we call that this one as real number system. Okay? Next. Example, using the set representation, given that R means real number, denotes that the set of all real numbers Z, the set of all integers, and Z plus the set of all positive integers. Describe each of the following sets. All you have to do is to describe. So first, we will describe this first, or we will read this first. Okay. We read this one as the set of all element X in R such that X greater than negative 2 but less than 5. So, dapat pag magbasa ka nito, uunahin nyo ang ibigkas si X. Ha? X greater than negative 2 but X less than 5. Okay, now. Okay, now the answer is the set of all element X in R such that X greater than negative 2 but less than 5 is the open interval of real numbers strictly between negative 2 and 5. It is pictured as follows. So kung nakikita niyo, yung real numbers is from negative 2 up to positive 5. So, hindi kasali si negative 3, hindi kasali si 6, positive 6, 7, and 8. So, yung X is from negative 2 up to positive 5 only. Okay, next. The letter B. The set of all element X in Z such that X greater than negative 2 but less than 5. Okay, so is the set of all integers strictly between negative 2 and 5 only. It is equal to the set of negative 1, 0, 1, 2, 3, and 4. So as you can see, hindi kasali si negative 2. So, negative 1 up to positive 4 only. Next, letter C. The set of all element X, Z positive, such that X is greater than negative 2, but less than 5. So, the answer is a set of 1, 2, 3, 4. So, as you can see, ang kailangan lang natin dito ay si Z positive. Or positive integers. So, the positive integers is 1, 2, 3, and 4 lang. Hindi kasali yan si negative 1 dahil positive. But, if the question is negative integers, okay. So, ang kasali lang dyan is si negative 1. Okay? Check your progress. Given that R, the set of all real numbers, Z, the set of real integers, and Z, the negative, the set of all negative integers, describe each of the following sets. Okay? So comment below your answer. Okay guys, comment below your answers. Next is subsets. If A and B are sets, then A is called a subset of B. Written A is subset B if and only if every element of A is also an element of B. So ito, kung anong makikita nyo sa set A, dapat makikita nyo din sa set B. Yun ang ibig sabihin ng subset. Proper subset. If A and B are sets, A is a proper subset of B if and only if every element of B is in B, but there is at least one element of B that is not in A. So na intindihan niyo ba lahat? Ha? Every element of B is in B. So dapat yung mga element sa B dapat intact pa rin siya sa B. Pero there is at least one element of B that is not in A. So dapat mayroong isang element, at least one element na hindi mo makita doon sa set A. Okay, that is proper subset. For example, let A equal a positive integer, B equal the set of all integers such that n is greater than 0, less than or equal to 100. And C equal a set of 100, 200, 300, 400, and 500. Evaluate the truth and falsity of each of the following statements. Okay. B subset A. So, nilinawin ko lang ha. Yung B niya, yan si set B, ito si set B. Yung N niya is greater than or equal to 0, but less than or equal to 100. So, yung numbers niya is from 0 to 100 only. Yan si N. Okay, question. Is it B subset A? B subset A. Okay. So, again, subset. If A and B are sets, then A is called a subset of B. Written A subset B if and only if every element of A is also an element of B. So kung ano yung mga elements sa A, dapat makikita mo doon sa B. Okay, now question is B subset A. So ito naman baliktad. Si 0 to 100 ba daw, makikita mo ba daw dito sa A? So, the answer is false. Why? Because 0 is not a positive integer. Thus, 0 is in B, but 0 is not in A. And so, B is not a subset of A. So, kung titingnan niyo, si A, yung symbol ni A is positive integers. For the positive integers, hindi kasali si 0. Hindi kasali si 0. So, that is why B subset of A is false. Dito naman si B, yung numbers ni B is nag-start siya sa 0 to 100. Then, i-subset mo kang A, si A, positive integer is nag-start ang positive from 1. Walang 0 sa positive integer. Gets nyo ba? Okay, letter B. C is a proper subset of A. So, just to recall, proper subset, if A and B are sets, A is a proper subset of B. If and only if every element of B is in B, but there is at least one element of B that is not in A. Okay, so that is a proper subset. Now, ang tanong ngayon, C is a proper subset of A. True or false? True. Each element in C, element means, can you see, is C 100, 200, 300, 400, that is the element. Each element in C is a positive integer and hence is in A. But there are elements in A that are not in C. For instance, 1 is in A and not in C. Okay? So, naintindihan nyo ba? So, makikita lahat, pero si A hindi makikita yung mga other na elements like 1, 2, 3, 4 sa C. So that is proper subset. Okay, letter C. C and B have at least one element in common. B, C. C is 100, 200, 300, 400, 500. At saka si B is from 0 to 100. So the question is, C and B have at least one element in common. True or false? True. For example, 100 is in both C and B. Okay? Diba si B, nandito si 100. At saka kang C, nandito naman si 100. Okay? Okay, next. Letter D. C subset B. C ba daw? Subset daw ka B. So, lahat ba ng element ni C, makikita mo ba doon kay B, that is subset? So, yes. A true or false? False. For example, 200 is in C, but not in B. Okay. So, yung makikita mo lang sa B is ang 100. Dahil yung the subset means every element of A is also an element of B. So, dapat, kung anong element dito sa set of C, dapat makikita mo lahat doon sa set of B. Kaso, anong nangyari, ang nakita lang natin na numbers is 100. Hindi natin makikita si 200, 300, 400, 500 sa set B. So the answer is false. Another, C subset C. Okay, obvious naman. So the answer is true. Every element in C is in C. In general, the definition of subset implies that all sets are subset of themselves. O, diba? C subset C. Si C ba daw? Makikita mo ba lahat yung mga numero kay C din? So, of course, true. Makikita mo lahat. So, that's it. Okay. Check your progress. Let A a set of 2 and a set of 2 and square root of 2 to the power of 2. B a set of 2, a set of 2, a set of 2, and C is a set of 2. Evaluate the truth and falsity of the following statements. A subset B. A subset B. So, lahat ba ng elements sa A, makikita ba mo ba daw sa B? Next, A, B subset A. Lahat ba ng element ng B, makikita mo ba sa A? Letter C, A is a proper subset of B. Ito ba daw lahat ng mga element ni A, subset, proper subset ba daw ni B? Letter D, C subset B. Or letter E, C is a proper subset of A. So, comment below your answers. Okay, next. Distinction between E and element and subset. Distinction between element and subset. Example. Which of the following are true statement? Letter A. 2 is an element of a set of 1, 2, 3. Yes or no? Yes. 2 is the element. Yung element, guys, yung nasa loob. Letter B. A set of 2 element of a set of 1, 2, 3. Yes or no? Answer for B to be true. For B to be true, the set 1, 2, 3 would have to contain the element a set of 2. But the only element of a set of 1, 2, 3 are 1, 2, and 3. And 2 is not equal to a set of 2. Hence, B is false. So, dapat, para matawag siya nga element, ito si set of 2, dapat mayroon din siya sa loob ng set of 2 din. Dapat magkapareho sila. Ang kaso, yung element natin dito, ito is only 2. Walang braces. Dapat may braces siya para matawag siya na element. So, our answer here is false. Letter C. 2 subsets of a set of 1, 2, 3. Yes or no? Okay. For C to be true, the number 2 would have to be a set and every element in the set 2 would have to be an element of a set of 1, 2, 3. This is not the case, so C is false. So, para matawag siya nga subset, dapat ito si 2 is set. Dapat siya subset. It means, dapat yung given is set. So, kaso, ito si 2 is element. Dapat meron siyang set, meron siyang braces para matawag siya nga set. Okay, ah? So, this is false. Pero, kung meron itong braces, kunwari, meron braces ito si 2, so, matatawag natin siyang set 2. A set of 2, subset of a set of 1, 2, 3. So, yung answer niya is yes or true. Okay. Letter D. A set of 2, subset a set of 1, 2, 3. Yes. Okay. Ito na yung kanina. Si letter C, tingnan sa letter C, walang braces. So, kaya siya nagiging false. Ito naman si D, mayroong braces. Kaya siya nagiging yes. Ha? Kuha nyo na ba? That is for the subset, ha? Iba naman yung sa element. Letter E, subset all. Letter E, a set of 2, subset of a set of 1 and a set of 2. Yes or no? True or false? For E to be true, every element in the set containing only the number 2 would have to be an element of the set whose are set of 1 and set of 2. But 2 is not equal to either set of 1 or set of 2. And so, E is false. So, there should be another set here para magiging true siya. So, set of 2 naman siya. Dapat meron pa siyang isang braces, ha? Para magiging dalawa. Dapat dalawang braces yung makita nyo dito sa 2. Ito. Para magiging subset siya sa other. Okay. Letter F. A set of 2, element of a set of 1 and a set of 2. Answer. Yes. Okay. So, kanina sa letter E, ito si set of 2 is an element only. Element lang siya. Hindi siya kung siguro, kung yung given dito sa letter E is element, so siguro check siya. Or check talaga. So, kaso subset. So, that's it. Check your progress. Which are the following are true statements? Okay, now comment below your answers. Comment guys, parami ng parami. Cartesian product and function. Cartesian product given sets A and B, the Cartesian product of A and B denotes A cross B and read A cross B is the set of all ordered pairs A and B. So AB, we read that one as ordered pairs, all ordered pairs, where A is in A and B is in B. Symbolically, A cross B equal a set of ordered pairs AB such that A element of A and B element of B. Now example, let A a set of 1, 2, 3 and B equal a set of U, V. So find A cross B. So how to find A cross B? So let A equal a set of 1, 2, 3 and B equal a set of U, V. Now how to find the A cross B? So first, make a distributive property. So 1 pares mo kay ano kay U, and 1 pair to V. So we can write this as 1 U and 1 V. So i-pair mo lang, si from 1 from set A to set B. Then gamitin natin yung distributive property. Next, 2 pares mo kay U at 2 pares mo kay V. Okay, that's it. 2U and 2V. Next is 3U and 3V. Okay. So, ganyan. So, the answer is a set of 1U and set of 1V, a set of 2U, or we can call this one is a set of ordered pairs. Okay, so the answer is a set of ordered pairs 1U, 1B, 1V, 2U, 2V, 3U, and 3V. Okay, next, letter B. Find B cross A. So, baliktad naman. So let B equal a set of U, V and A a set of 1, 2, 3. So just follow the pattern above. So the same pattern distributive property. So U pares mo kay 1, U pares mo kay 2, U pares mo kay 3. So U1, U2, and U3. Next, V naman. V partner mo kay 1, V partner to 2, V partner 3. Okay, so the answer is the set of all ordered pairs U1, U2, U3, V1, V2, and V3. Letter C, find B cross B. Okay, so B cross B, let B equal UB, and B set of UB. Okay, the same pattern. So si U partner mo kay U at saka si U partner mo kay V. So UU and UV, and V partner mo kay U at saka V partner mo din kay V. So the answer of letter C is the set of all ordered pairs UU, UV, VU, and VV. Okay, let's proceed. Letter D. How many elements are in A cross B, B cross A, and B cross B? All you have to do is to count the elements. Okay, letter A, A cross B. 1U, 1V, 2U, 2V, 3U, and 3V. So, A cross B equals 6 elements. And B cross A, the same, have 6 elements. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And letter C, B cross B, four elements. So 1, 2, 3, 4. So that's it. So check your progress. 1. Let Y equal a set of A, B, C, and Z equal a set of 1, 2. So find Y cross Z, third letter B, find Z cross Y, letter C, find Y cross Y. So comment below your answers. Okay pa ba? Kaya pa ba? Kaya pa ba? Okay, that's end of discussion. I hope you enjoy and you understand my discussion. So don't forget to subscribe and comment below all your answers, guys. So thank you so much. So until next discussion. So we'll see you here in our in my channel, Earth Boutique. Bye bye.